Yes, I'm well.
Emmett?
Yes?
Who told you to cut these? Who showed you?
Exactly. Who showed you how to skin these?
Well, see, I'm a deputy. I've learned a lot, and I've been taught a lot. There's certain logistics that come with it, and I've rised up through the ranks. Actually, I'm quite important around here.
They've taught you wrong since you lived here.
I'm certain that they haven't taught you how to skin an animal, because by this, what I'm looking at, I mean, this is... You ruined it, honey. You ruined it.
Daddy, you got a knife?
Terribly sorry.
It is unusable. It is not of the standard.
It's just cut to shreds. You don't have any proper lines. It's just, it's appalling.
Just teach him, Luther.
Trying to impress the family was always hard. Never mind a new job. I finally found myself a woman, and they didn't even think she was real.
Braithwaite's.
Right.
A fine establishment, right?
We won't miss, a working woman at the dinner anyway. You know, we don't need that.
I still believe she don't exist.
Well, maybe that's why he's now saying that she might not show up. She's coming up with a story.
What does even a working lady like that even look like?
You know what? That is a good question. I wouldn't even know. I don't know what working women look like. I've never been around one.
You know, I somewhat hold somewhat of a record of six arrests in 1 week. It's somewhat of a record around here.
Just six?
Six? That seems a bit low.
That is quite low.
Inside a week, it's exceptional.
You know, that's not even one a day, Emmett. I mean, I would think you'd be getting multiple per day.
Especially if you're trying to impress this working woman.
It's just a little dirt. It's just a little dirt on my face. Like I said, Emmett doesn't know how to drive the carriage. He's flinging all the mud and dirt around, and it just, flew into my eyes. It's fine.
Well...
And just like that,
what's happened to you?
It started.
It's nothing big. It's nothing big. I just got a bit of dirt in my eyes.
Nothing to worry about.
Oh, be it.
Well,
thought that they'd come into my house and kick their feet up? Who do these people think they are?
Man. What a wonderful idea. A trip to the pictures. The moving pictures, Uncle.
We have to. You know you love pictures, Luther.
Next time, yes, I promise you, it will not happen again.
Pardon me.
Yes?
Could I just ask, did you get an invite down here?
Excuse me? What are you talking about, honey?
No, I just wanted to know. A couple of people said there were some people coming down. I was just interested if you were part of that or whether you was just exploring the place.
Oh.
I don't quite understand what you're trying to say.
Oh, I just wanted to know if you were part of the people that were down here to sort of hang around and have a nice time.
I mean, this is my home, of course. Of course, honey. Of course.
Right.
LD, why don't you fuck off, huh? I consulted with one of my family members about what we would do with our current predicament. See if we can get people to actually go out. Boy, was that a mistake.
Do all the mining for us, because I'm not getting in those things. But once we get that set up, a lot of people, all they're worried about here is getting married. Couple guys always tell me I'm so pretty and things, so that'd be kind of easy. But I think for myself, I'd head the sales department. Go around selling to people. Get some advertisements out. Because apparently these people can just wipe their ass with money out here.
What do you suggest?
Well, Auntie was thinking like $50 a week for people to just to protect us, but that'll probably be nothing to them. We're hiring workers, and we can do some interviews. How about that?
Uh-huh. Have you heard about the recent problems that we have with trespassers?
No. Fill me in.
So you understand that these people have been poaching, poking, and looking for an angle to work on this place?
Yeah, I understand.
You understand the sacrifices that we'll have to make. I don't have to tell you.
Well, if you're going where I think you're going, that means you got to be careful.
The woman that I wanted y'all to meet. Sheriff Nelson.
Now. Mr. Fitzpatrick, you see how I'm smiling now?
I'm entwixt with her. Is that the right words?
Yeah, let's say that. So what's gonna happen between y'all?
Following deep lust. And hot. And sweaty.
Damn it. You know, I don't want to know all those details.
Yeah.
It's the only way I see is protecting this place and keeping it ours.
I'll see what I can do. See who can be hired. Don't you have a soiree to attend or something in Rhodes? For high society likes?
Yeah, I was going to meet some people. Are we done here?
Oh, well, if only my dear cousin understood at the time that I was just getting started. Obviously, this couldn't be tolerated on our property. I had to hire help. I mean, I dreaded to think what my mama would think. But, in the thick of it, I felt optimistic. I am a Braithwaite, after all. So, I threw myself into my work, and I found myself looking for a missing person.
I see his I think the wolves are over there still. I don't carry a gun, Deputy Braithwaite.
Well, where is he?
Oh, there's Ram. That's where I think he was.
Get away from me! No, stop making me! You're putting bacteria in my wounds. It doesn't work on a human being. Get him! He stole my food!
Jesus!
Oh my god, Agent, what happened to you?
I started fighting wolves, and two of them, one of them bit the back of my calf, and I fell, and then I hit my head, and they started just eating all the food that I was carrying.
Okay, well...
He tried to act nice. He was licking my wounds. I probably totally have... You know, lupine flu now.
With lupine flu in the air and corruption lingering, the faith in the department, well, it varied. I mean, I knew me and my colleagues, we were a little bit on the ropes.
Lesson number two.
But I had high hopes, aspirations. I was gonna do this department proud. I was gonna do my family proud. I just didn't realize at the time how big of a task that was.
Everyone, I'll keep this short. I'll keep this sweet. I know many of you have not had a chance to meet me yet. My name is Marshall Wade Phillips. Currently one of the senior law enforcement personnel in this area of the country. And we have some bad news we need to discuss with everybody. Fortunately, upon the convening of an independent review board ordered by the Associate Director of Operations for the United States Marshal Service, three cases of corrupt law enforcement individuals were found here in the crossing. All of these individuals have either been dealt with or are deceased due to their own actions. Now, I understand this is not a good thing to hear, but the only positive note I have for you is that upon the convenience of this board, those were the only officers that were found. So, you think anybody else in here ain't trustworthy, you say so now. And if you have something to hide, and you have something that you ain't supposed to be doing, you have a few days to deliberate and turn yourself in or discuss with myself or one of the deputy marshals. Is that understood, everybody? There will be no more corruption in this department. And if there is, we will root it out and we will eliminate it before it affects the people's perception. Is that understood?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, Marshal.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Outstanding.
Yeah. That lasted long.
You can't imagine what it looked like. The faces they made.
Someone's here to arrest me, yes, of course.
Oh.
Come with me, please.
The stares they gave me.
Maybe so. You're being charged with aiding and abetting in the case of a serious assault committed by another law officer. So how do you plead?
Guilty.
For weeks after I got out of jail, even when I put the badge back on, people didn't even want to be around me, Emmett.
Shit. I didn't even want to be around them.
So if this investigation happens, if it even opens, if it looks like things are going south, I'm out of here.
With corruption at an all-time high, I threw myself into my work. We got a tip-off that some illegal activity was going down in the casino. With the clientele they were keeping, I think I was on to something.
Marilyn, come join the ladies' corner.
Wait, where's the ladies' corner?
Over here.
Gonna be cool? Okay, yeah.
More like the bitch ditch.
Oh, try my hand at roulette again.
Love the moves.
Marcy.
I ain't interrupt, Emma.
This. Out of Braithwaite.
Can I take this great man right here off to the side real quick? I don't mean to interrupt.
Oh, no, you're fine.
Holloway, I need you to do me a favor.
Okay.
Go up to the bar counter and order one of those coconut drinks.
I haven't got enough money for it.
$15.
Yeah.
Go buy one.
Why?
Just buy one.
Okay.
One on both.
Well, you think are so? You leaving this man to me
here? Probably out of Maryland.
Well, thank you so very much for your... You've been fantastic.
And if I win the raffle, you'll be fine.
Absolutely. I have your ticket number. You are ticket five.
You think it's gonna keep going on black?
Indeed.
Could I get one of those coconut drinks?
Honestly, every time I think of something that doesn't happen, so I just wait for it. Much.
This is good. Here's some money. Oh, wonderful. Thank you. This will help with my transplant surgeries.
You look like you're sorry.
Oh, wonderful. And please, do I know about your event? Very much like to attend.
I think it will be a maybe. Saturday, maybe 2 weeks from Saturday. Probably Friday.
Thank you.
Wonderful. How wonderful.
Well, thank you very much.
A pleasure. Thank you very much.
Right then, Mademoiselle Marilyn, I do have to be going. So I've come back here behind the bar to keep it back.
Okay, okay,
okay.
Okay.
Right, take care, man.
Here we are. Mwah, mwah, mwah. There you are.
Come here.
Oh! Oh.
This is what I think it is.
Gimme. All right, enjoy the rest of your night. Leave it with me.
States Cross and Sheriff's Department. This is a legal search and seizure. I'll stop the search and seizure.
Everybody remain cool. Would the staff please join the bar?
People gonna be crazy. Ah! People gonna be crazy. Crap table flipped. Ah! You know, people throwing chips at each other like frisbees. Oh, Christ.
I'm gonna shout first.
Search and seizure.
After you, miss.
Oh. Go ahead.
After you, ma'am. Everybody. Saints Cross and Sheriff's Department, we have a warrant for search and seizure.
It's a raid!
Everybody, please remain calm. Steph, please step to the bar. So who's running this operation?
That would be me.
So where do you see yourself in 5 years?
Emperor.
Emperor?
Where do you see yourself?
5 years? Oof. Well, so long as I'm not 6 foot under, I'd like to think I was still carrying on, doing good work, and I don't know, maybe Deputy Marshal someday?
Of course, one moment. Am I paying you to slack off?
No, sir. Sorry.
For your starter, you have spring vegetables and butter.
Oh, thank you. Oh, this looks lovely.
Yes, sir. How would you like your steak prepared?
Medium rare.
Yes, sir.
And I'll be expecting it to be medium rare. Last time I got a steak around these parts... Ugh. Barbecue the fucking shit out of it. What do you think? What would you do? You have any dreams outside of work?
I'm not sure. I never really thought about it. I don't know. This is all I've ever wanted to do. I mean, I guess I could settle down, maybe do something simple.
Yeah, Braithwaite has also asked for some entertainment while you have your dessert.
Mm.
Oh, excellent. Yes, that
would be. I walked across an empty land. I know the pathway like the back of my hand. I found the earth beneath my feet, sat by the river, and it made me complete. Oh, simple thing, where have you gone? I'm getting old and I need something.
All right, the fruit that dangles helplessly is piteous and needy. But firm in grasp and full of seed, but not so desperately, is likened to a beacon.
one may follow safe to shore. Comfortably you may swim those waters, but one might sink to the floor, praying without motive, accepting to complete a meal made of the favorite fruit, more bitter than is sweet.
Is this the place that I've been dreaming of? Oh, sympathy, where have you gone? I'm getting old and I need something to rely on.
Was it something I anticipated? Not at all. I had no idea I would fall in love with my sheriff. My senior. My Gertrude.
I mean, I... All right, well, yeah, I love you. Good night. Rainbows, everything that's wonderful is what I feel when we're together.
Would you be interested, if the time comes, if it ever comes, to be a senior deputy and maybe a sheriff someday?
It'd be an honor. And I knew all my hard work was paying off. I had the woman of my dreams, I had promotion around the corner, an award ceremony coming up. Oh, I was shoo-in. Oh, you look wonderful.
Thank you, so do you.
Sit in the back. There you go.
All right.
And I just knew that all my hard work was going to pay off, and I was a shoo-in for a few awards. I just know it was going to be my night. Yeah, that lasted long. Thinking back now, I should have never went.
Both of those. You can have both of
those.
Okay,
thank you. Oh, hey, Emmett, do you want to know what the first question on the love train was?
Sure thing.
It was, who would be the worst person in the crossing to marry, and why is it Braithwaite?
Wait, say again? Go from the start?
The first question they used on the love train that Mr. Cathal used was, who would be the worst person to marry in the crossing and why is it Braithwaite? I just figured that'd be something you'd want to know. Also, hi.
Everybody was out tonight. You're the most beautiful woman in here.
Oh, shit.
I'm smitten. I think I want to say it. Before the awards. Before they start up the awards. Nelson. I love you. Anywho, we see about them awards.
All right. Well, I would have to say, I'm rather glad that I was chosen for this award. I do try the best I can to make sure I am best dressed for the occasion and whatnot, but, other than that of me being best dressed in this occasion, there's another person, at least, I would like to bring up here for a minute.
Here we go.
I would like to bring up Walsh for one good minute.
Oh.
What's that?
I'm sorry, love you. Come on. Don't be scared. Having someone alongside that is quite lovely and as equally as well-dressed, I've gotten a bit of inspiration from her as well, too, so... definitely give it a round of applause for her.
Where the hell's he going with us?
Yeah, come on.
Aww. Oh, isn't that just cute, everybody?
Hold on.
Oh, there's more.
Hold on.
The play is not done.
Well, I think in terms of...
You got the damn bell.
For us being well-dressed and perfect for the occasion, you know, a good number of people have known the majority of us two to be together for quite a while, and I think in many ways I've thought quite a bit about things here and there, and it's been a long time coming, but I felt it would be rather appropriate for a situation.
Oh my God.
No better than this, but take the chance to and marry me?
Are you serious? Yes?
Yes.
Quit.
I had to take out the time to go and do that.
No, not tonight. Why tonight? This is supposed to be my night. Why would he upstage me like this?
I
would like to officially welcome and thank you all for coming to the Sheriff's Ball of 1900, everybody. Can we get a warm round of applause?
What?
Yeah, that's right, yeah.
Take care.
This is going to be the worst dressed award. This was an award that was requested. I didn't put this in.
Stupid.
So let's just like put that out there first before we start. The worst dressed award is an award that is much sent with love as it is a heartfelt intervention. No, you really don't need to pair that jacket with that top. As much as these officers may lack a certain je ne sais quoi, they make up for it in heart. Welcome our nominees. Peterson, Braithwaite, and Muggsy.
What? There's got to be some type of mistake here. They got to have a mistake in here. I was supposed to get a good award tonight. I was... What?
Goddamn.
Get on up there.
Embarrass me like this. Make me look like a laughingstock.
Curtain Twitcher Award. We present the Curtain Twitcher Award for their feats in a unique characteristic to never been able to tell when enough
make a mockery
are
of
just
me.
Enough.
What's
they
the
are ever
with...
vigilant and they
why?
Suspicious. These officers display a sense of duty that is earnest, but sometimes delightfully misguided. Welcome on.
Don't particularly have a reason to believe they're particularly dangerous. I don't think they pointed their wait. They've taken people. They've kidnapped people for sure. But we don't know for sure if they've committed any violence. So let's try to de-escalate if we do see them.
After the department made a mockery of me in front of the whole county, I threw myself back into my work.
I was falling that blood track there, I thought. Just about on the edge of it now. I mean, there's a few camps that I think.
Camper looking for a person strung up.
Seeing Aurora.
Oh my gosh, we really do not.
We're at a serious disadvantage.
Yeah, I'm gonna get my gun out because I can't see shit with binoculars.
We could very likely be shot at any moment.
There's a camp over there.
Thank you.
Nothing they thought.
Jesus Christ.
Across the sheriff's department, do not resist. What do we have here? Muggsy.
Up there. There's one. North.
Get him?
He's up here.
Says across the sheriff's department.
He threw an axe at me. Don't take me. No. No. You can't do this to me. You can't do this.
Feast.
Yeah.
You keep your hands off me. You touch anything on me. The biggest mistake of your life.
A little bit more forward.
No! Oh.
Bring him higher!
Fellas! I...
Is it good?
No! Yeah, no!
You reckon we could probably eat you? Heck, dope. Before they get here.
We could strike a deal even before that, and it would be beneficial for everybody.
Unofficial?
It'd be beneficial for everybody.
Beneficial. I don't know about that.
A little bit further, sir.
Over here?
Where we are. Perfect.
Let me know.
Looking pretty good, isn't it? Mm.
Oh.
Hey.
Whoa.
We have someone here. If you leave, we will dare. We will kill him. If you leave, we will kill him. Oh, easy. It's the locals. If you leave, we will kill him.
You got to come closer to here.
I can't hear ya.
If you leave this area, this man will die.
I understand.
How are you feeling?
I've got an axe in the shin, so that's about how I'm feeling. What's it gonna take to get him out of here safe and sound? What do you want?
We want to know why you are in our woods.
I've got dead bodies all around this forest.
Yes.
I had to come and investigate, you must understand.
What exactly happened, boys?
We had some friends over for dinner, and then Sheriff come and shoot us all.
Yeah, yeah.
We came down to investigate. He wouldn't have opened fire on anyone. There were people running away from the camps crying cannibal. What exactly are you doing, sir?
Help, help me.
Prepare dinner. What you doing?
Your deputy came close to our camp because she got a report of a man on a horse, yes, earlier today.
Yes, and I've had several more reports of you guys terrorizing folks in Strawberry and elsewhere. Can you explain that?
No, no, that's not true.
What do you mean by terrorize?
I'm sure it must be some misunderstanding. You seem like fine folks, from what I can tell.
Lies! We are not fine folk. You try to sugarcoat me.
Listen. What can I do to get my deputy out of here? We've got no quarrel with you. If you want to keep this land to yourself, that's fine. We will not interfere any longer. Who's in charge here? Who am I speaking to? I'm Sheriff Nelson.
Looks. He smiles at me.
The name is Joffrey.
Joffrey.
We wanted to live freely in the woods, and you and your people come to disturb us. We told your deputy to leave and never come back. She came with a group of what it seemed to be civilians.
Understand right there, he seems to have slipped.
That we are acting in our defense, that we want no quarrels.
Is that why there are bodies, human bodies in your camp strung up?
Would you like to know?
Now let's all calm down, everybody.
Would you want to see?
Someone is up there.
Stay up there. I advise you wouldn't do that.
If you are behind me,
stand down.
I will kill this man.
We were going to strike a deal.
With your deputy.
Sheriff, we were going to strike a deal. Talk to him.
Folks, now listen to me. Who's it, Joffrey? Listen to me.
Yes.
This doesn't have to be anything more than pleasant conversation.
If there are no consequences to your actions, and you will never learn.
100% can be
supplies, done. Sheriff. Supplies. Get them supplies. Food. No supplies. Cornbread. No supplies. Medical bags, they'll do it for that.
No, we can leave the horses.
They need the supplies.
Shut up. Braithwaite, shut up.
Seems that you, Sheriff, and the gentleman above us are not on the same page.
No, we're not. It's clear we're not. But I'm telling you, on my honor, if you let me live, I will give you those supplies. I'll come back, no army, and I'll get you the supplies.
Need to,
You know I'm good for it. You know I'll do it. You know I'll do it. With this.
Good.
We're just going to circle around the issue. You know?
Then let us...
What do you actually need? You must have needs here.
Yes. Well, first off, you need to leave the forest and never come back. And, well, there is one way I can assure that. And it is by killing this man.
No!
Kill them all!
You're the one that's mended that break. And you got me so full up again. And I don't know what I'm gonna do without you, so you better not goddamn die. Because I really do need you, and I really love you.
So you're just gonna have to buck up.
Friends, family, and loved ones, we come together today in the sight of the divine and of you as witnesses to join Emmett Braithwaite and Gertrude Nelson in marriage. Emmett and Gertrude have proclaimed your love and commitment to one another in the eyes of these loved ones, with the power vested in me by the state of Saints Crossing, the city of Blackwater. I am happy to pronounce you husband and wife. You may kiss.
Thanks, man.
Yeah.
Sheriff.
Evening.
Nerve.
And here I thought we were very close friends, briefly.
Hey!
No, but you can imagine with having security around, things like that would not happen.
Watch it, Emma. After the attack on my wife on her wedding day, I thought about taking justice in my own hands. But like anything, the department turned its back on me.
And I've heard too many things about you in the recent past that I can't, without good conscience, sit here and not do something about it. I hope to God you're clean, but I've opened an investigation. And I want to be upfront about that to you.
If it looks like things are going south, I'm out of here. I'm done. Because I won't let it happen again. And I respect everybody I work with way too much to have them to have to work around someone that reminds them. It's gonna affect the job. It's gonna affect public image and opinion. And it's not worth it.
I gave my life to this job. And this is how they treat me after they've embarrassed me time and time again. I don't understand why the department turned its back on me. Did I not risk my life for the job? Did I put my life on the line every single day for the department?
Mr. Braithwaite.
Huh?
Here I have documentation that reads the following. Deputy Braithwaite, Lord of Braithwaite Manor. By the request of Sheriff Gertrude Nelson Braithwaite, these papers are being served to you to inform of imminent divorce with immediate
effect. Whoa, there's no discussion here?
I need to read this in whole. The ceremony, which was held on August 13th, 1900, is to be believed to be hosted as a ruse for Ms. Nelson's hand in marriage. We will be seeking compensations in the sum of property ownership of the Braithwaite Manor, ownership of one male Arabian black horse.
This is a joke.
Recompense.
This is a joke.
Of $240 every 2 weeks.
This is nonsense. Gertie.
Sheriff Gertrude Nelson felt pressured into a loveless marriage.
Pressured?
Due to a poem that was received and you felt jealous. While she holds a higher station in the professional industry, you demean her by making her inferior in the personal life. Ms. Nelson also declares that after many weeks of being wed, one encounter to consummate the marriage was certainly lacking. And as of serving these papers, your marriage has been made void under the Saints Crossing Law.
No, not just like that. What, there's no discussion? I can't fight this?
If Sheriff Nelson is to be re-wed, the spousal compensation may cease. Sir, by all means, you are more than welcome.
Gertrude, let's talk about this. Gertrude. Honey. Darling, what was the meaning of this?
If you want to hire lawyers, then we can see each other in court.
No, Gertie, talk to me here. It's me.
You will have to go through myself, and for you to speak to me, you will need another representative.
No, me and my wife are going to talk. That's
she
what we're going to
no
do.
She is no longer your wife by this document, sir.
No, she's my wife, goddammit.
It's written in paper right there. She's no longer your wife.
You will also owe myself $250 for the fees.
Shove it up your ass. Gertie, come. We're leaving. This is nonsense. This is nonsense.
Come, sir.
You shut your goddamn mouth. Joe, I thought better of you. Gertie, come. We're going to talk about this. None of this shit. Shame on you fellas.
Ms. Nelson, please take a seat.
Shame on you fellas. I'm taking my wife and we're going to go home.
She's not yours to take any longer, sir.
Gertie?
Oh, baby.
Gertie?
Hey, if you want to talk to him, I'll go with you, Nelson. I'll be there.
You don't need this.
I am handing you this book. You have now been served the papers. It is official. You are divorced.
Sorry for your loss.
Gertie, please, listen, this is nonsense.
All you have
you're
to do
rushing.
Is sign those papers and then we're
sign.
Going.
I'm not signing nothing. You're rushing into this. We're leaving. Shame on you, Joe.
We need to be paid. You can blame me, Braithwaite, but.
No, Joe, you stop goddamn whispering in her goddamn ear because you've done enough.
What the hell happened?
I'm not sure.
Gertie, please.
We'll just have a talk.
You want me to stay here?
Get lost.
Joe! It's not Rhett what's happening. We're not Rhett together.
You're just... We've just had a little rough patch. You know?
Rough patch. Baby...
Darling, it's me here, okay? It's the same guy, sitting by the campfire, singing. What is this? Where'd this come from, huh? None of this. They just whisper nothings, okay? Filling you up with a bunch of nonsense. You can trust me. Listen, I've been hearing your worries, okay? You know, I've been listening to what you say. You ain't feel comfortable in the house. You know, I've ordered some new linens. You know, I didn't buy the 50 ounce, about the 100 ounce of that fucking perfume or whatever you like and stuff. I know you don't like the Egyptian cotton, but I'm getting new things. You know, I'm gonna make it home. Okay, we can work through this.
I have to tell you something, and
let me start. Let me just tell you, okay? Listen, these rumors, the rumors that Joe was saying, I mean, he gave me Deputy of the Month. He gave me that award. How could he say this? I don't know why he's not taking my side here, but these rumors, they will never go away. I see that now. And I think we can, I think we can both agree it can't go on like this. All right? So, I thought, fucking rifle off my back. So I thought we could take this opportunity without distractions to lay our cards on the table and talk frankly for once, okay? And we know that a few things need to change to make this marriage work, okay? And we're going to make it work, okay? Because we're stronger than this. We're not going to let these this shit. I don't know how I feel. Okay. It's my complaining. It's incessant. I ain't whining, whinging like a child. But are you surprised? The way these god-awful mustaches and seniors, they run the department and continue to infantilize me. When all I ever do, when all I ever do is just seek their approval. When I'm met with do this, don't do that, say this, not that. I mean, can you imagine anything more humiliating? To make it work, to make it bearable. You know, I need respect, acknowledgement from those dreaded mustaches. And I'll stop calling them that when they don't all fucking have one. An end to their snobbery and their prejudice. No more being sniffed at for being a Braithwaite with a background nobody really understands. Ooh, he's got an auntie, a high propriety. They know nothing. But that will never happen, will it? No, no, no. I will earn the respect with the only thing that these creatures understand, Gertie. Is a gesture, a statement. And that's all I ever wanted was to strive for in my position, okay? And it's put me under immense pressure. And if it spills over the top of the cup, I'm sorry, but you are always the one to fill it. You mean more to me than much. Divorce lawyers. Listen, I'm not sure I'll ever understand most things. Maybe I'm blind, or lost in my role, or lost in myself. Christ. Look, I realize this marriage hasn't turned out to be... Well, it has turned out to be quite something quite different to what we both imagined. And that we both find ourselves in a situation that is unique. Because our marriage is different from any other marriage in this county. And I promise you, darling, okay, this restlessness of mine is a thing of the past. And I'm going to do what I need to do for this marriage.
Now I know for sure we must get divorced.
What?
Because I don't deserve you.
Joe, I'm having a talk with my wife here.
I'm sorry, Nelson, but I have to be honest. She's in love with someone else.
What the fuck are you talking about, Joe? I'm not talking to you. You're not my senior right now. You're not my superior right now. You're a fucking man on my property. What the hell are you saying?
I'm telling you the truth. I'm being honest. You're my friend as well, Braithwaite.
Darlene. What is he talking about? What is this nonsense?
Baby, listen. I don't know how to put this. I'm in love with O'Malley. Because I can't do that to you. And regardless of how he feels, which I don't really know, it's not right me putting you through this.
Divorce, huh? Sign papers. Okay, one condition, though. we go on one last little boat ride. Like we used to. And I'll sign whatever papers you want me to sign.
Don't sign those papers, Braithwaite.
I don't need to get no lawyers.
Okay. Be back, Joe. We're just gonna have a little chat.
I'll be right here. You better come back, Nelson.
No, nothing's ever happened between us. We haven't even spoken about anything. So please don't get upset with him because he doesn't really know.
All right.
I may not always love you, long as there are stars above you. You never need to doubt it. I'll make you so sure about it. God only knows what I'd be without you. If you should ever leave me, well, life would still go on, believe me. Emmett? Emmett? So what good would living do me? God only knows what I'd be without you.
A loveless marriage?
Look, I mean, you're gonna be fine. You're just gonna bounce right back and find a nice Miss Marilyn or somebody like that. Who's gonna fit right into that role? What are you doing?
Why wouldn't you talk to me? Why did you never let me know anything? You didn't let me know anything. More time and often I opened my heart to you. That would have helped.
You don't make it exactly easy.
I bet you he did, didn't he?
That's not fair.
No, this ain't fair. You reading it?
Yeah. Baby, I'm sorry. I never meant for it to be like this.
Yeah, I bet you didn't.
sure it's true when you say I love you. It's a sin to tell a lie. Millions of hearts have been broken just because these words were spoken. I love you, yes I do, I love you. If you break my heart, I'll die. So be sure it's true when you say I love you. It's a sin.
Hi, mister. You need a bath?
Be sure it's true when you say I love you, honey. Cause you got sense enough to know it's a sin to tell a lie. Whole lot of folks' heart is done been broken just over a whole lot of foolish words that's been spoken.